So last week, we began the class with the definition of cooking from the Oxford English Dictionary, who defined cooking as the transition of food under the application of heat. You will recall that we recast that definition as a plot because we're scientists and we like to make plots. And so we plotted the temperature on an axis and we drew a line and we said below some critical temperature, the food is uncooked, and above that critical temperature, the food is cooked. We also are able to, on that plot, put different foods. And so, for example, here is the phase diagram of an egg. So you know that below some critical temperature, an egg is uncooked. An uncooked egg is essentially a liquid. You can sort of shake it up and down and feel that it's a liquid inside, whereas a cooked egg, when you cook it above some critical temperature, it becomes a solid. So I'm going to just flash up a couple of different materials and show you what the behavior looks like, and then we can try to put this all into a broader perspective. This is the phase diagram for water. There is a critical temperature, which is about 0 degrees Celsius, below with which water is a solid. It's ice. And there's a critical temperature above which the water transforms from a liquid to a gas. And you all know that that occurs at about 100 degrees Celsius, at least if the pressure is 1 atmosphere about sea level. So nitrogen has a phase behavior that looks actually, for all intents and purposes, a lot like that of water. At room temperature, nitrogen is actually a gas. You can make nitrogen into a liquid if you cool it enough, and it turns out that the temperature at which nitrogen transitions from a gas to a liquid is about minus 195 degrees Celsius. So it's very, very cold. If you cool it a little more to about minus 210 degrees Celsius, then nitrogen will become a solid. So here's another material that's important for cooking. This is ethanol. So ethanol, of course, is something that many people like to drink. If you're enjoying or not enjoying today's lecture with a glass of wine in your hand, then, which is recommended, by the way, then the wine, of course, has some amount of ethanol that's in it. So the temperature at which ethanol transitions from being a liquid to a gas occurs at a slightly lower temperature than that of water. It happens at about 78 degrees Celsius. That's why alcohol boils off more quickly from a dish than water if you're ever using wine or something to make sauces. Ethanol also can become a solid, and to do that, you have to cool it more than you have to cool water. The temperature at which ethanol becomes a solid is about minus 114 degrees Celsius. But the point that I want you to take away is that the general phase behavior of ethanol also is exactly like that of water, and it's exactly like that of nitrogen. It's just that the transition temperatures are changing, and in particular, it looks nothing like that of an egg.